So, in the last episode of Nine Fingered Wrenching, we got this Sea-Doo. She'll turn over. We put a new battery on it. Still hadn't got it to start. We're going to go ahead and squirt a little fuel in the carbs, see what happens. Let's see. Okay. So she wants to live. She wants to breathe. Fire. Yeah, we got some fuel issues to work through. So we're going to have to figure out what's going on there. Looks like we're going to be popping the carbs off, going through those. After this Sea-Doo with some purple power and a pressure water.
It's a greasy mess everywhere you look.
I did cover up the carburetors, took the battery out. All right, so let's get after it. Now we can get it in the garage and start digging into it. It'll be a lot nicer to work on now. All right, let's get in here and get these carbs off. Get them loose. So the way the gas pumps, when the motor goes through a cycle, pressure from the motor comes through here and makes this pump fuel. I think it's called a pulse line.
Got a pulse line loose. It is 10 millimeters.
Alright, so I usually try to leave one nut where it was. Loosen it down. Get it off of there and then tighten that nut back up against the other one. That way you kind of know where it was from when you took it off. Make life easy. Alright, there they are. Now we get to go take them apart and see what's inside. All right, so this is our mag carb. It goes to the front. This is the one where the fuel comes in. It's also the one that gets the pulse line hooked up to it. There's a connecting fuel line feeding this carb. And then this is the return line that goes back to the tank. As you can see, they're asphyxiated all together there. Well, there's those screws that we don't want to lose. Oh, two with washers and two without. I guess those washers are optional. You don't need those. All right, let's go ahead and start detaching the two from one another. See if we can get some meat on there. Well, it's gonna be that way, huh? We'll just go ahead and do it with all of them. Little impact drivers are handy when these things get all kind of froze up. Let's start with this one. And that's not right. Oh, mercy. Man, I've seen a whole lot worse as far as when you open that up and what you find inside. These are notorious for stripping. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh. Somebody has stripped them. Oh, but that one's loose. I got it. Holy cow. Oh, they're loose. Holy cow. Well, I'm gonna have to get some replacement screws because those are not gonna work. Reuse the spring that's in it. Don't guess it, hoping you have the right spring in whatever kit you bought. Supposed to be an O-ring, and I think it's underneath all that crustiness there. That's definitely going to have to be replaced. Another thing you look at on these, try to look and see if there's like a, if you see a groove around the end of it, and there's definitely a groove around the end of that one. We'll be replacing those. On the back side of this, there's a little bitty plastic flap. Little tiny check valve. Let's go ahead and take off our pump side. See what we find. Somebody's been in this recently, I think. There's not any fuel in here whatsoever. Right here, I knew I saw it somewhere. They make a little spot just for this occasion. And you can get in there and get a flathead screwdriver and pop it apart. Okay, so there's absolutely nothing in here like I would expect to find in an old carb. I mean, things are not in good shape by any means. I mean, that filter clogged up. The parts of the kit itself needs to be replaced, but man, I would have expected to find a bunch of sand and all kinds of corrosion and stuff inside of here. So somebody's been in here and tried to do something with these. Oh,
got her notepad. Here's her Shar Pei. Typically kind of assume that the adjustment screws were in the correct position. So this is our PTO side, and we're going to look at our tie screw first. That's maybe an eighth. PTO high, 1/8. There's a half, 1 1/4, 2 2 1/4, 2 1/2, 2 1/2. That's not right. 2, say 2. All right, so we got this ready to soak in the bath. Soup's on. How long should we let it cook? What do y'all think? Oh yes. Let's do it for 30 minutes. I'll just leave you here with that. Enjoy it. I love y'all. I wouldn't do that to you.
All right, so we got our cards all cleaned up. Everything's all nice and shiny.
We're missing a couple of things. This carb didn't have the spring, so we got to get another spring. This carb, the screws were stripped out, so I really need to get some new screws. So I'm going to have to order some things before we can put it all back together. I did get the rebuild kit and everything, but it just doesn't have all the parts I'm going to need.
We can go ahead and work on the rest of the fuel system.
The original fuel filter canister is supposed to be right there. It's gone. There's a fuel selector. Well, let's go ahead and see if we can get the stuff out of the tank.
Wait, that thing's tight. I think I almost got it, but my goodness. Come on. Why is it fighting? We got this. Why you?
I love working on old Sea-Doos. They're so easy to work on. Said nobody ever.
Come on. Who are you?
If I ever go mountain climbing, I'm gonna take a bunch of fuel one. Because if I fall, I know it's gonna get home on something.
Just think about everything for a minute. Get this out of the fuel tank. And it should just come up out of
it. I love working on little things.
I think we're about to drain the gas tank.
I hooked it up to the reserve. We're gonna see how much gas we can get out of this thing.
Tank's pretty full.
The gas that's in there doesn't look horrible. I'm running it through a filter. That way, if there's any kind of trash in the bottom of the tank, maybe I'll catch most of it.
There's one strap loose. Then we have to get this.
I
little gasoline. It's running down my elbow.
It's gasoline. Well, it's a bunch of gasoline. I wouldn't have thought there would be that much in that pipe.
That was it.
Yeah. Well, I spilled most of it.
Maybe I'll try this again.
Oh, it just came apart.
Okay, there we go. Gas tank's out. Oh, yes. Whew. All right. Now we can check that thing out. They call this a sending unit, actually. It goes down in the tank. It's got all your, got your vent, on, turn, and your reserve. All right, let's look and see what the tank looks like. Yeah, there's some trash down in there. I don't know if you see the trash in the bottom of the tank or not, but there's some in there.
All right, we're gonna wind up this episode right here. We got the carbs out and taken apart, took out all the fuel lines, took out the sending unit. We took out fuel selector. Now, a lot of people say I always replace these. Sometimes I take them apart and clean them up. What do you think? You think we need to replace the fuel selector or clean this one up and see what happens? Put it down in the comments. Let me know what you think. Once again, I want to say thank you for tuning in to Nine Fingered Wrenching. Hope y'all have enjoyed the show. In the next episode, we're going to put those carbs back together, run some new fuel lines, put the tank back in, and see if we can get this old girl to fire up. Then we can find out what else is wrong with it. Hope to come back for more. We appreciate it. Don't forget, like, share, and subscribe. Thanks. Peace.